Welcome, friends and subscribers. This is an artist's world, and today we're painting an English canal. Thank you for joining me today. This is a 12 by 16 inch canvas, and we're starting out just ensuring that we get the correct placement for all of the different major items. I typically start out with my darks and then finish up with lights and so on, but sometimes I choose to do the intermediates as well. And there's many different approaches to painting a painting, and after a great deal of experience, you find out which one will work for you the best depending upon the subject matter. I begin some of the darks, entering some of the darks, and trying to ensure that the painting is developing correctly. I also begin placing a lot of the tree structures. You will want to reduce the intensity of grasses and so on way in the background because of atmospheric perspective. What you want to do is, by reducing the intensity, you're going to add either a gray to that same level, or you're going to add some of the complement. many artists are scared of doing reflections, but reflections are easily controlled if you just think value, the correct value in the right place. And that's normally always the truth. The major thing that you want to get right in your paintings are value. Color is just icing on the cake. Here's a great pointer. If you don't know what color you're mixing, you can't really put a name to it. You can't tell whether it's green, blue, red, whatever. Be reassured, it's because it's a combination of all three major primaries. So therefore, make sure that you use all of them, and you'll find that one of them dominates. And so it's because it's a gray. It's a gray that's a nondescript. Yellow is the first color that is likely to be reduced, and it goes from yellow, orange, to red, and so on. So if you find yellow up in the front, you're not going to find that same yellow in the background. It will be reduced in intensity, and to reduce it, once again, add the same value in the grayscale with gray, black and white, or better yet, using a little bit of the complement. The complement will, however, lean it towards other colors within the primaries. So watch out for that. Here I start putting in some of the dapple light holes. Watch out so that you don't overdo this. Remember to, as in this illustration or this painting, you notice that some of the darks are being added later. And possibly this should have, you know, a lot of the darks should have been added before, but if you have to add some of the darks to accentuate those after the fact, a little bit later, then just ensure that you have more paint on your brush. Then it'll pull it off. The paint that's existing paint will pull off the paint that's on your brush. Remember that all paintings look pretty bad in the middle to three quarters of the way done, but what happens then is it transforms into something beautiful. So remember that. Just keep on plugging away and don't be afraid to change things, but of course it's always best up front to know exactly what you're painting, what you're going to do, and have a good idea where those values are going to be placed. Don't just take a picture and then just copy it. No, that's not the way it's done. You have to accentuate those things that you want to bring out. You're the artist. You can move things around. Notice how close I've scooted the bridge up so that it can be seen. I accentuate some of the colors. I accentuate those things that I want to bring forth to your attention. Color is used after the fact and detail. But the most important part of every painting is correct values. Finally, that little guy in the middle, the fisherman, he's finally put in. These are all details that are put in towards the end of the painting.